Welcome to part 2 of my video on finding inspiration. Link up here in case you missed the preceding one. The best way to see if my favorite strategies to find inspiration for art can help you too is to put them to the test. This new invitation to paint is a personal challenge because everybody wins just by participating. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art, yourself and the world around you. The assignment is simple. Go outside, step into your garden or visit a nearby park, go to the beach, climb a mountain or whatever. I don't know what your options are close to home, so you can choose. Perhaps try to visit a new spot as an extra challenge to stir things up. Or if you don't want to, pretend you're new here. Maybe throw in some anticipation, like you're going on vacation. And observe and take pictures with your camera or phone of things that catch your eye. Take some of the landscape, take some shots of details, and also a number of somewhere in between. Let me show you how simple it can be. Next to our house we have a let it go and let it grow area. What I see is this tree trunk, with a nice shape and interesting colors. Here's a slice of it, a little different. Or this fence board, what has been there for 2 years now. I love the leaves on it, the colors, mosses, algae and so on. And how about these bricks? No two are alike. You can't touch them, but you probably see they have a rough surface, which you can translate to a textured surface. These roofing tiles get different colors over the 10 years. And look at this trash can. I love the dirt pattern on it. I clean them once every year in summer. Why bother? It's a trash can. And now I can show you this interesting dirt pattern on it. And one treasure after another, and any one of them can trigger me to get creative again. Another example. A few weeks ago we had snow and cold weather for a week. These blackberry bushes look like a mess. Standing more or less on the same spot, I noticed the snow emphasizes the lines of all branches, making it suddenly look magical. So again, I can do a wide shot, getting closer or focus on details. Another idea is to walk around with a passepartout, looking for an interesting composition and take pictures. After going for a walk in your garden or elsewhere, you have all these pictures. Look at them and choose 4 or 5 you like the most and use them as an inspiration source for an abstract artwork. Use whatever art material you feel like. Work in whatever size, use whatever color scheme, in short, do whatever, but do it abstract. And that's my number 4 favorite source of inspiration. Do, do and do. Do something, anything, but please do. Because doing also pulls me out of my black circle, I talked about in the preceding video. Some time ago I made a video about this aspect of my artistic process. Link up here. You have 14 days to submit your artwork. A little pressure can help perhaps also, so please send them in before March 15, 2021, to be included in one of my next videos. In the description below the video you can find my email address. Please also send in the 4 or 5 pictures you used as an inspiration source. Next to your artwork I want to show your first name and the country you live in, so also put them in the email. I'm already looking forward to receiving your artwork. I will do the same exercise and show my artwork in the video as well. Just like we did it with the artwork of Robert and Sonia Delaudet a few weeks ago. In case you missed it, click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video.